Hi everyone, thanks for joining us on this episode for the Elm Sports Network. I'm Andrew Cherico, and sitting beside me today is the men's baseball head coach, Matt Reynolds. Coach, thanks for joining us.
My pleasure.
If you look back to last season, you guys went 18-15, which was the first winning season in 3 years. What kind of positive direction would you say the team's taking?
Well, I think that was big for us last year, just to get things heading in the right direction. I don't want to say turned around, because it was only, the season prior to that was 16-20, but it was good to get on the plus side of 500. That was one of our goals going into the season last year, is to be at least above 500, and we ended up right at 500 in conference, and fell a little bit short of our other goal was to get into the Centennial Conference playoffs, and through a tiebreaker situation, we ended up not getting in. However, we were picked to finish 10th out of 10 in the conference, which I think the guys took that as a little bit of bulletin board material, and I certainly don't blame anybody in the conference for thinking for ranking us as such. But last year was a very motivated team, a very hungry team that was they were really ready for some change and ready for some direction and some coaching and so forth. And they really took to it, and it was a fun season. Unfortunately, it fell a little bit short at the end, but it was definitely a step in the right direction, despite not quite getting to where we wanted to be at the very end.
All right, Coach, and on a very positive note, let's start with the pitching first. You guys bring back a lot of experience, but we'll focus on pitching for right now. You guys bring back five regular rotation starters on the mound. That's including guys like Dan Jarrell, Billy Griffin, John Beck. You got Logan Dubé on the mound starting now. Well, how is it a plus for the team to have all this experience back on the mound?
It's huge. It's probably the most important aspect of the team going into this season is that we've got guys that, and it was a little bit unfortunate last year of how we found out about. I'll put a PJ McCoolis and a John Beck. We knew that John had obviously had some historical success here, so we knew what he was capable of, and PJ was a freshman, and we knew he was throwing a lot of strikes, and he was just kind of waiting for his opportunity, but it ended up being where Casey was a starter for us and got a little bit nicked up, and then it was the next man up, and PJ got his chance and did outstanding, and then Beck got a chance, and he was outstanding, so it was a little bit unfortunate last year of how these guys got their opportunity, because it was through some injuries, but it turned into a plus for this year, because we know that we've got six starters that we've got a lot of confidence in, and it's created a lot of competition, which is great, because eventually when we get in the Centennial Conference, it's going to be really a Tuesday, Friday, and then two guys Saturday rotation. When it really, really counts in April, and right now we've got six guys fighting for those four spots, which is great. And then whoever ends up being five and six out of that, you got reliable guys coming out of the pen to go along with a bunch of guys that have already proven themselves that they can help us out of the pen in a Bartels and Papalizio and Weiss and freshman Billy Benson has shown some promise and many others as well. We don't want to leave anybody out of that mix, but certainly having that depth and it beats going into a season trying to figure out where the fourth guy is going to come from, rather than who's the fourth guy going to be amongst these three guys. So it's a big positive for us, and we've got as I'm sure we'll talk about, we've got a heck of a stretch come spring break where we're playing. I think it's 9 games in 8 days, and then if you stretch it out further than that, it's something like 13 or 14 games or 16 games in 17 or 18 days or something like that. So it's you need that depth, and we pay close attention to making sure we're not overusing our arms, and you need a lot of guys that have come in and throw strikes to be able to get through that without throwing one away or putting a guy in a bad spot and overextending them. So
yeah, definitely a big plus, to have all those arms ready to go. So let's shift over now to experience. Like I said, you guys lose one starter from out of the nine, and that second baseman, Brian Alexa, who's gone. How's the experience a plus for the team?
It's probably 1 and 1A along with the pitching. Brian what was an outstanding player. He had a career year. He was our most improved player. He was awarded that at the end of the year. And he's tough to replace. Great guy. And was just a positive impact on the team all around last year. You know, Joe DiPaola and Sam McGovern, you know, threw innings for us that are going to be tough to replace, of course. And we lost two of the really better players in the league, but we didn't know what we had last year. I didn't know what we had in Scott Matthews and Dennis Thomas because, you know, they were injured. So as it turns out, yeah, we're from a position player standpoint, really only losing one everyday starter. You know, Kyle McCoola chipped in as well last year, and his bat is going to be tough to replace as well. But, yeah, it beats, you know, losing four or five guys and having to figure that out. So, you know, it's created a nice little competition again at second base where we've got a couple guys, Addison Hanscom and Mikey Pugh and a freshman in Luke Diastilio, who have really competed hard for that position. And Luke got the first start the other day and did very well. Actually had the triple that broke the game open. But as I told everybody before the game, you know, I have to write nine guys in the lineup for this particular game, but that doesn't necessarily mean anything. That competition is ongoing, and that's a good thing. That's a positive thing, especially going into the stretch that we're going into, where we're going to need depth positionally as well. So we'll see how that shakes out, but hopefully we can do our best. We can't replace Brian, especially as a person, but you know, we'll do our best to compete. And we've got a couple guys that I feel confident are going to compete hard for that job and do the job admirably.
That competition, you know, must be good to have along, you know, the players and coaches, just to see how people, you know, play hard every game. You know, positions can't be taken for granted. Mm-hmm. So let's look over to that spring break now. You guys travel down to Myrtle Beach, which actually I'll be calling the games. Very excited. How are you? Do you preview the games, and how excited is the team?
I think, you know, spring break is always a great time. We're once again going down to the Ripken Experience in Myrtle Beach, and I really enjoy it down there because I think the field quality is fantastic. They're all field turf fields. You know, you're going to get your games in, barring a huge thunderstorm that's going on during the time that you would actually be playing. So that's a positive for us. It's a nice atmosphere down there. We stay at a great place. We're right on the beach, so I think it's great for the guys to just be able to get away from school for a little bit, take a deep breath, and just focus on baseball. And this year in particular, we're playing more games than we did last year. And we've got seven scheduled at Myrtle Beach, and then we've got a doubleheader here on the back Saturday. So it's going to be very, very busy down there, but it's exciting. It's a fun place to go and play every day, and you're playing some teams that you wouldn't otherwise get the opportunity to play out of region. So we're very excited about it, and it's also a time where, and I told the guys this last year, those games count just as much as any other game. However, just due to how many we play in a short period of time, we do have to get some other guys in there to preserve our starters and also to give earned opportunities to the people that are competing and deserve and have earned an opportunity through practice. And that usually comes up during spring break because there's so many games to play. So that's another exciting part for the team, is that they know that we're going to go down there and compete hard to win some games, but there's also going to be some opportunities down there for some guys that have been, you know, practicing hard and getting it done in the weight room and just anxious to get their turn, get their number called. And I'm excited to see how we react to it.
Yeah, you know, every game, every inning is going to be exciting down there. Mm-hmm. All right, so last question here. What are the goals and expectations to finish out and, you know, for the entire season?
Well, I mean, certainly for us, it's not an unreasonable goal. You know, after seeing last year, it's not an unreasonable goal to think that we can win this thing. That's not something that's 2-3 years away. You know, I don't think that is. But, you know, I like to take it. I like to take things one step at a time. And so, you know, that the conference championship and going to regionals was not necessarily something that I brought up with the team when we discussed goals in our first team meeting, because we've got to show that we can be a consistent team that stays above 500. So that's another goal, is to improve on our record overall from last year, to take that extra step and get ourselves into the playoffs. You know, that obviously has to come before winning a conference championship. But those are our two main goals. But if we can accomplish those goals and get ourselves into a four-team tournament, I love our chances. I love our chances because we're not going to run out of pitching. knock on wood. If everybody stays healthy, we're as well equipped, I think, as anybody in the league to survive a 3-day, 2-game elimination style, because we can roll some guys out there that there's not a huge difference between our 1 and our 3 and our 2 and our 5 and so forth. So I think that's something that makes us a little bit dangerous in that format. So I'm excited. I hope we can get in there and then do some damage in the tournament. Get ourselves to the regionals. That's the goal.
Definitely. Coach, thanks for joining us. We look very forward to following you guys this season.
My pleasure.
We're now joined by the men's baseball senior captain, Brian Bakker. Brian, thanks for, coming down and joining us.
Absolutely.
So, you're the solo captain for the team. How have you embraced the leadership role?
Just trying to get everyone together and go out there and play hard and just try to get everyone to do the same thing, It's really just a matter of going out there and doing it and helping everyone else and trying to get everyone else to do the same thing. So,
all right, last question here. Senior year, you've had a very long and outstanding career with the Washington College baseball program. How do you want to finish your career?
I'd like to finish just with a successful season, honestly. Go further than our program has so far. Just go out and play good baseball every day, and as a team, I think we'll go out there and do big things, and then I'm sure that'll translate to me personally, hopefully having a good season as well. So if we just all play well together, I couldn't ask for anything more.
Definitely. Brian, thanks for coming out and taking the time.
Absolutely, no problem.